All right, we've got a Razer. This one apparently was working, all of a sudden shut down. Let's see what we can do for this job. So it came in without a battery, as we requested. It was mailed in. Now we got a... Is this a Type C or the round jack? Oh, bummer. It's got that... I didn't realize it's got that charger. Okay. Alright, no problem. Okay, so let's see. Wow, that's a giant heatsink, okay. Quick photo. There's one screw missing there. We don't know if the fan needs to come out together or not. We'll do that anyway. Mm-hmm. crazy design, huh? So these two are smaller ones. Okay, let's take the whole motherboard out. Wow, that's incredibly heavy. Okay. So this has been all opened. Why? Okay. So let's have a look at the point of charging port. Here, so this has already been fully disassembled up to this point. Yeah, I just hope nothing was done on the board to reduce the chance of it being repaired. Okay. So let's get some measurements. Okay, this board has a huge number of fuses. Okay. We don't have a direct short on the 19 volt rail. What's the resistance of the 19 volt rail? That is low, in my opinion, for a 19 volt. Yeah, okay. There is a component shorter to itself. So middle is the positive pin. Looks like a diode. Yeah. One side and the other side. Okay, let's see if we can get a battery voltage. That's okay. So the cable resistance is going to be that. Let me double check another place. Yeah, that's pretty accurate. Okay. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Relative, we can work with that. Let's check. Oh well, that's fine. That's the BIOS chip, pin number 1, pin number 2, 3, 8, 7, 6, 5, Okay, OL, 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 double check my probe is good. No, my probe is not good. Okay, that ground is different. Alright, let's go again. 185, 189. Okay. That is a serious concern. That's ground. That's positive. May be fine. Let's not assume the worst. Huh? Wow, okay. Okay. Let's see what's going on here. Gate to source, dual MOSFET. Gate to ground. Is this diode any good? Looks good. The other way. The other way. Okay, let's check in. Let's check in. This is unusual for that to be shorted. Okay, let's go ahead and remove this. It's a CMOS battery. All right, we have to remove him. The resistance is too low. It looks like the shunt resistor. Then they put a connector right next to it. Really? Come on. All right, let's see where the short is. Is it on system side? Most likely system side. Yeah. All right, okay. Let's go ahead and do an injection. Now, it would be nice if I can remove this. Normally there's a lot of heatsink, thermal paste and whatnot. Wow, look at that massive giant GPU. This guy means serious business, okay. We're gonna do a controlled voltage injection. We'll start at 0 point something. And we'll see what happens. So we're going to do 0.6 And if needed, we'll go up. But maximum, probably maybe one. We really don't need to. It's a dead short to ground, so. Alright, do your magic. Ah, do that again. Gotcha. Second, was that the middle one? Okay, here we go, third one. Okay, let's check. Where is this short? We are in diode mode. One, two, three, this guy. So this is one of the power phases for the CPU, and if we are lucky, CPU is not damaged. If we are not lucky, CPU is also gone. We don't know. Let's just remove him. That particular one there. Before we remove him, let's check the resistance of the coil that it's attached to. I mean, all those coils are on the same rail. Sorry, to ground. Yeah, we are like dead short, okay. Only 0.2 difference. Let's check the coil to ground. Yes, no, stay up. Maybe the heat is still wearing off. So the coil to coil, I mean just the direct resistance, here we go. This is just, here we go, coil to coil, which is the cable resistance if you like. Now to ground. I think we've got a good CPU, maybe CPU survived. Very high chance. Yo! Okay, wait. All right, I'm coming. All right, we might have ice cream. Okay, let's see now. So CPU is fine. Now where the hell do I get one of these? I might have this one because there was another job I did. MPNR, you need 86941 if I remember. 86941. Oh, I remember this one. I got 86961234, I think. Let me check. Okay, cross fingers, we got it. Let's have a look. What was I after? 86941. Damn it. I got 86.93, 86.90, 86.94. Where can I find that? Yeah, I've got some Razer motherboards, but they don't have this MOSFET. Their ones are bigger. This is a HP gaming. Look at this motherboard comparison to the other one. Just want to see what's under here. Yeah, I have cleaned this board already, but I use different MOSFETs. Okay. Okay. Okay, we'll put this one on the side. But honestly, this MOSFET that has failed has done a good job of protecting the system. Alright, I'll make some inquiries, see if I can find it. So, we don't have this part. No matter. I'll put this on the side for now. It's good to check the GPU as well while we're at it, because what if the GPU is also gone? Just check the resistance. This one has to be dead accurate. Okay, let me get them right. Come on, man, bring me that old number. I would say that's fine, even though that's a very, very low resistance. How low can low get? Okay, and to ground here. Can't believe how low resistance the GPU works. It's mental. I get scared when I see those numbers so low. Let's put this guy back, and our 19 volt should go in the mega ohms range. So let's go ahead and fix this up. For getting the plug there. Oh yeah, come in. All right, we'll put the job on the side, see what the client wants to do, and we might have a part two coming up. See you in the next one.